Welcome back to Later with Leon. And hey, listeners, a lot of times you don't get to sit down and talk to comedy royalty. Well, I got a chance to. This young lady has been killing it across America, and you might know her family. I spoke with Shante Wayans. Shante, what's up, man?
Hey, what up,
Shante Wayans in the building. Listen, I'm glad you're here. I'm glad you took some time out your busy schedule to talk to me, because I know you working and you hitting these stages. What is it like being a traveling comedian? Because people, a lot of times you don't appreciate that. You get like a sitcom or something, and then you miss the road. Yeah. Like, what is it like being on the road all the time?
You know what's funny? I don't like the travel part. I don't like
flying
getting on
the plane
and having to do that stuff.
Okay.
Especially when you got like a quick turnaround.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? It's like, it's just too much. I wind up getting clear, even though I didn't want to do it, because I was like, nah, the government and getting my fingerprints again.
Again.
But then I was like, all right, I got to do this. But I like being in different cities. I like meeting different people, different cultures.
What is the first thing you look for, like, far as dealing with your set at night? Because I know me, when I go to a city, I want to find out the worst neighborhood. You know
hilarious,
what I'm saying? And once I find out the worst neighborhood, I already wrote 4 to 5 jokes
to open
the show. What do you look for when you first come to a city?
The bed. real talk. I want to go straight to the hotel. I could be starving. I could be everything. But if I don't get sleep and then wake up and try to figure that out, then I hate everybody.
Okay, so now when you're on stage, what would you consider your style of comedy? Like, is it storytelling?
Storytelling for sure.
Okay.
Storytelling for sure. I like to talk about my life and, you know, the things that I've been through.
A lot of y'all don't know, like, I hated growing up being a Wayans. A lot of y'all don't know, like, most of my family, you know, half of them was rich and half of them was poor. Like, I felt like the Cinderella this summer. I used to go out every summer and visit my rich side. I'd be going to red carpets, meeting mad celebrities, going to premieres and shit. Then I had to go back home to the projects. I'd be looking at my mom like, you don't know how to tell a joke?
Okay, so, well, let's talk about it. When you say you're talking about you and you talk about your life story, you're a woman that... Yeah. Like women.
Right.
So do you consider yourself, when you're on stage, a representative of the LGBTQ community, or you're just a comic that has an outlook on that lifestyle?
I would say the outlook. I mean, I definitely want to represent them, but in the right way. I think, you know, as we know, everybody's getting sensitive. There's so many, you know, political things you need to be careful for. But the truth is, like, I'm kind of split in the middle. I understand men and I understand women. Mostly, you know, a lot of things I'm like, yo, dudes, I get it. But I feel like that marries the world of straight and gay. And that's how I was able to, like, build my comedy and really show a different side.
And I say that because it's already hard in this gay community. And you got a lot of those gargoyles trying to cross over. Well, let me tell you something, you unattractive If you are unattractive in a straight world, 10 times out of 10, you are unattractive in a gay world. So stop bringing your ugly ass over to our side.
One of the jokes I'm doing now is like, I want, my biological clock is ticking and I want to have kids. But as a stud,
people like, what?
Especially in the black gay community, they like, what?
What?
And so much so that I'm like, do I want to spend $30,000-$40,000? Or do I just want to do
the
right old-fashioned
way
and take one for the team?
Right.
The problem with that is it might not work the first time.
You just got finished hooping with the homies. Hey, Steve.
I'm like, hey, yo, you want to hit this? You know what I mean? They be like,
I mean, you got the genetics. I mean, you averaging 20 out here.
Right,
cool.
right.
The only good thing about being a Wayans was I was the only girl in high school that dudes wanted to get pregnant. It's like, that's a Wayans baby. We gonna keep that one.
Shante, when did the comedy bug hit you?
You know, it's crazy. I remember going to a comedy show, seeing my cousin perform, and I went back home and couldn't sleep. And I literally thought of like 2 jokes, and went back to the comedy spot the next day, did an open mic, and wind up being asked to do the main show. And that was
off
like...
Off of two jokes,
yeah.
Wow.
It was,
so
you know,
like,
it was open mic.
Did you do any ad-lib or freestyle in front, or you just went right into your
set? No, I think I went straight into it. It was like...
But you tell stories, though, so...
Yeah.
It kind of, like, with little long jokes, kind
of?
Like,
well, the one of the things I had was... I can't tell my guy friends about my dates because they... they get too much into the story.
Right.
So it was like, you know, I took this girl on a date, man. She was just so loving and amazing. They're like, right, but did she have a fat butt? I'm like, yeah, that was all cool. But, you know, then I walked into the door. He was like, so did you smash? I'm like, man, let me finish. So it was like this long trail of like me trying to explain this like loving date. And they just keep trying to figure out what's that. Yeah, yeah.
That is hilarious. That sounds like us, though. So at the end of the day, when it's all said and done, you're moving around. What is your end game? What is the end game for Shantae? You know, like what do you want people to know? Because you know you got that name, Wayne. So a lot of people gonna feel like you have a head start.
Yeah,
I talked to Tony Rock about that once in a private conversation. He's like, yo, a lot of people feel like I had a hard start because Chris is my brother. Mm-hmm. Yeah, he's my brother, but I still had to be funny.
Mm-hmm.
So what is your end game? What do you want people to know about you when it's all said and done?
For me, I just think it's I worked hard for what I did. You know what I'm saying? Like, I grew up with rich families, but I also had a poor life for a long time. Mm. You know what I'm saying? So I still had a struggle. I still had my own things that I was dealing with. It was sabotaging and all that stuff. And really, the end game is that I survived and I made it through on my own.
No doubt. Any big movies coming out? Anything you're producing?
Hey,
you getting in the production side?
You know, right now I'm doing some development stuff right now, and so trying to push that. But I'm touring. I got like 3 different tours I'm doing. I'm headlining myself. I'm touring with Tiffany Haddish, and
nice.
We got this Woman's Work with myself and Ida in April. From the They Ready special.
Thank you for stopping by.
Oh,
I appreciate
absolutely.
You so much.
Thank
what can they follow
me.
You at on Instagram?
Everything is at C Wayans. Check out my website for upcoming tour dates, cwayans.com. What was that?